Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to North Campus Fieldhouse. The LT Lyons facing off against the Hinsdale Central Red Devils. I'm Campbell Schumacher, joined alongside Tyrese Shines here. And, I mean, Tyrese, I know you've been away. You've been at college, former LT alum. I know these games, when you're playing career here, were huge. And what does this matchup mean to you as a spectator now and then as a player?
Well, I mean, playing against Hinsdale Central, probably one of the best games in the state. I mean, we have a rivalry match like no other. I mean, I played in the game for 4 years, played these games for 4 years. It was a fun time. I mean, the atmosphere is great. There's loud all the time. And when you're out there playing, you kind of get a little adrenaline rush throughout the whole entire game. But the goal is to beat Hinsdale Central. I hope that's what we do today.
Yeah, I mean, last matchup, I believe a week and a half ago, LT defeated the Red Devils 48-45. We saw big games from the two big men down low, Brady Chambers, Liam Taylor. Chambers had 23, Taylor had 16. And it looks to be another very close match against tonight. Obviously, whiteout is the theme tonight. Fans will be here. It's a Saturday night, so everyone's out doing stuff, so a lot of kids will be here. But, yeah, I mean, pretty similar records. Central has the bit of an edge. LT coming in at 9-15, 4-6 in conference. Central sitting at 13-14 and 5-4 in conference. So, yeah, it should be a fairly evenly matched game. LT, I would give maybe a little edge to LT just with the home crowd in their favor.
Right. I mean, it's going to be a great game. I mean, I've never played on a Saturday against Hinsdale. It's always been on Friday night. So, hopefully it's a good one. Hopefully LT comes up with the win today.
Yeah, and we will see you back for tip-off. Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you back just before tip-off here at the North Campus Fieldhouse. As the LT starting roster is getting announced, I'm Campbell Schumacher, joined alongside Tyrese Shines. As we talked about in the pregame, Tyrese, obviously, we know your experience here is huge, especially in these matchups. Like, you know firsthand what it is to be like in these games. What nerves and what are these LT students feeling right now?
Oh man, I mean, to start this whole game, you got the whole crowd going crazy. I mean, you're feeling like you don't want to go into this game scoring 0 points. You don't want to go into this game losing. So, I mean, it's a lot of nerves going through your whole head. But at the end of the day, it's all about the environment and everything that's going on. So it's going to be a great one.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we saw Michael Riley just the other night. I think he was 6-for-9 from beyond the arc. So he had a huge game. So he's in LT starting roster tonight, along with Caleb Greer, Brady Chambers, Max Hoffman.
Oh, here we go. Ooh. Okay. In the zone to start. Oh, wow.
So they're gonna call an offensive foul there. I believe that is on Tyler Thick, their center.
My first time watching them in person, so I'm excited to see what happens here.
Yeah, Hoffman now holding the ball up top. It's over to Liam Taylor. Now Riley Chambers trying to find a look, driving on Thick. Now Greer. Back up to Chambers up top, across to Hoffman. Inside to Greer. Guarded closely by Kuzak. Greer to the cup. Up and in. Ooh. That one's just off the mark. No foul called there as Danielle Rosco pushes it the other way. Zales, corner three.
Oh.
Just off the mark by Dylan Dell, and the crowd loves it early. His Greer up top trying to make some moves. Slides it over to Chambers. Greer lets that one fly just off the mark. Rebound Chambers. Greer to the hoop again.
Nice. With the left hand, we love that.
Yeah, you love a little switch there. Trying to get a better shot off. Game position on the defender. Great
good
track
D.
there by
okay.
Hoffman and Taylor.
That's a...
Kuzak back up top. Rosco lets that one fly.
Oh, yeah,
that
good rebound.
Off.
Let's push.
Great rebound nice by push. Chambers. Chambers is also a type of guy who can run any position on the floor. You know, he can shoot. Great playmaker as well. His career trying to settle in here. Guarded closely again by Kuzak. And that's Dell guarding Riley closely. That one's poked by Kuzak. Oh, he lays out. Greer's going to take it back. So LT's going to get a bit of a reset there on their offensive possession as Will Kuzak does a great job playing defense. And foul against Hinsdale. I believe it is a push on number one, Will Kuzak.
So much different watching college versus high school. I mean, in college you play halves, 20-minute halves, mm-hmm. and high school you're playing 8-minute quarters. It's such a different game, but hey, let's go LT.
Hoffman, that one's blocked by Orozco. Rebound and kept alive by Fick. Now Central trying to push the pace. They want to get some points up on this board. That one's inside to Fick. Back door to Kuzak. Reverse lay is good. Great pass there by Fick. Just underneath to Kuzak, and he lays it in. As Greer trying to settle his offense down. Michael Riley now gives it off to Hoffman. Hoffman back over to Riley, trying to drive on Dell. Lay, that one is way off the mark. Rebound by Daniel Orozco. He's going to take it up. Drops it off to Kuzak. Uzalis. Orozco lets it fly. That one is good. Daniel Orozco gets the lead for the Devils. Chambers now inside to Taylor.
Nice.
Taylor, that one's up. Right off the glass.
Nice, good. Nice. Good job.
So Tyrese, what have you seen early so far from this Lyons team? What are they doing good and what do they need to improve
on? Well, I mean, they're trying to attack the basket, which is really good. They're getting up in Hinsdale Central with great defense right now, so yeah, hopefully they can start making some more shots.
They just caused a turnover there.
Oh, we love
that. Jump ball, that was great defense by, I believe, Taylor and Riley, and they're going to go off as Ian Polanowski and Tyler Kuda sub in.
Ian Polanowski, his brother.
Yes,
Division
brother Nicholas,
getting
some good playing time at Penn. That's awesome to see.
Oh, I guarantee in his sophomore, junior, senior year, he'll get way more. It's just
for sure.
It's just a freshman curve you got to get
over
at times.
Yeah, he's getting good minutes as a freshman, too.
For sure, 100%. I think he's averaging like 7 points.
Yeah, he's doing
well.
Chambers surveying the floor now. Greer with an open three. That Ooh. One's just short. Hoffman swats it away and Central will take over. New group coming in for Central. Jimmy Pajowskis coming in for the Lions, though, replacing Caleb Greer. And that is coming in for the Devils. Daniel's brother, Dylan Orozco.
Central's third section, not too many people today. I mean, when I was playing,
good,
they were
good group, but not a ton.
For sure.
Eric Kozis in as well for the Devils. And I believe number 44, Michael Howell. So, new look for this Red Devils offense. It's Buzalis inside to Howell. That one's up and in.
Good contest.
Great contest there, but just up and over as Devils extend their lead to 7-4. That one's inside to Hoffman.
Ooh.
Underneath Chambers trying to hold on. Great defense there inside by Howell and thwarts the attack from Chambers down low. It's Dylan Orozco now corner to his brother. That one's good. That's Daniel Orozco's second three of the game as Chambers come down to the other end, lays that one in. Does get the foul at the end though. Draws the foul off Michael Howell. So Chambers will go to the line, but Dana Orozco hot to start this game. Two threes already. Gives Central a 10-4 lead early. So
summer, 22, a senior?
Yes, Brady okay. Chambers is a senior. Yeah, from what we've seen so far this year, all the guys are seniors except for Ian Polanowski, number 35. So Ian will be the only junior out there, at least from what we've seen. Chambers drains both, cuts the lead for the Devils down to 4. So Central has really picked up the pace here in these last couple minutes. LT trying to play this zone defense well, get a trap. They had one earlier. Kuda, Pajauskas, and Raleigh doing a good job defending up top. It's a Roscoe now. Uzalis to the corner. Just off the mark is Eric Kozis. Pajauskas trying to push the pace down the floor now. Over to Riley. Michael Riley stays nice. Hot from beyond the arc.
Nice.
Coming off of a 6-3 game. He had 6 threes in his last game, and he stays hot tonight. That's Uzalis. Orozco's got the hot hand. We'll see if he pulls. That one's from deep. Just off the mark.
Good box out.
Yeah, good rebound by Liam Taylor there. Pajauskas now running point, surveying the floor. Riley will see if he wants to pull or not. Here goes Kuda. Finds Polanowski. Back to Taylor. He lets that one fly. Just off the mark. Rebound by Uzeli. That one. That is in for Dylan Orozco. The brothers are on fire tonight to start this game. They give Central an early lead as they continue to tack onto it. That one taken away. The brother to brother. And the foul. Daniel and Dylan Orozco are destroying the Lions defense early on in this game. I mean, what do the Lions need to do to slow these brothers down?
Well, first off, they need to slow it down a little bit and pass it more around the arc so they can get some good shots and not have as many turnovers. You see right there, there's a quick turnover to an and one. I mean, we can't have that. But it's early. It's only 15-9. We still got some more time.
Yeah, definitely a lot of time left, but the two brothers, Daniel and Dylan Orozco, I mean, Daniel's got 2 threes already. He just had a steal there. He's got a chance for a 3-point play. His brother Dylan just hit a 3. So, yeah, these two brothers are controlling the Lions right now at this point. So, yeah, they definitely need to, like you said, slow it down, take their time. They've been solid on defense, but I feel like the later it goes in the possession, they kind of let up those open threes, and Central has converted on those multiple times now.
They're hitting some hard shots. I mean, the hands in the face when they're knocking down the shots. So
definitely deep shots, yes.
Hopefully, Hinsdale Central cools down a little bit.
As Orozco finishes the 3-point play, as number 23 senior Dylan Reddy is going to check in for Daniel Orozco. No changes for the Lions after that timeout. Pajauskas now trapped. Gets it off to Riley. Over to the corner, Taylor.
Ooh.
That one's long. Good rebound by Pajauskas to get in there. Riley lets it fly.
Ooh.
Just off the mark. Polanowski trying to fight for the rebound. Good job by Polanowski to fight for that jump ball, but Hinsdale Central will get possession. LT making some changes now. Greer and Chambers checking back in for Kuda and Pajauskas. So LT now going full court press. Is that the move here? Full court press to try and switch momentum?
I would say so. But I mean, if they break it a couple times, they're gonna have to stop. So hopefully it works.
Yeah, full court press. It'll obviously leave some holes open for Central to score quickly on the other end, as you see.
Well, it's pretty good defense, okay.
Yeah, quick timeout by Central. They don't like the look they got from that full court press by the Lions, so they're gonna talk it over, try and maybe slow their pace down. I think you're right, though. I think the Lyons keep up this full court. It's worked a couple times. They had a turnover earlier in the game from it. I think they continue that. But I think they need to find these open looks on offense. They're taking these contested threes that are really not going their way. Like you said earlier, they were getting to the hoop and they were getting points that way, and I think that's what works for them against this team.
Right. Settling for jump shots is never it. So hopefully they can change that up. That's going to be a long game if they can't.
Yeah, early 7-point lead here for Hinsdale.
But you know, these games change that and all the time.
Yeah, well, as it's said, basketball is a game of runs. So.
For sure.
Obviously, we know these teams and crowds hate each other, so they're getting at it, going at it all game. You hear all the chants. It's Kosis now, Central slowing the pace.
I wonder if Illinois would ever get a shot clock for high school.
I always thought the same thing, too. Like, they can just take as long as they want as Howell drives, lays it in.
Rebound.
Good defense, Chambers. Yeah, good rebound, Taylor. Greer is open. He just launches that one.
Wow.
That one is good. Nice. At the buzzer. Huge three by Caleb Greer.
Nice. We love that.
I was confused there for a second, but realized end of the quarter. I'm like, why is he shooting that? And he lets that one fly, and just it is flush right through the bottom of the hoop.
One for a second.
I thought it was too, but great shot there. That is a huge momentum swing at the end of that quarter for the Lyons. They needed a big shot like that. And Caleb Greer, he loves those contested fade, step back threes. And as we take a look, he just drains it. Boom.
Boom. Love that.
A great shot by Greer. And I got to ask you, Tyrese. I know you've had some great moments on the court here during your time as a Lion. You had the dunk at the end of the game against Central. I don't know, I think it was maybe your junior year. You brought the house down. What was your favorite moment? Doesn't have to be against Hinsdale Central, playing for LT basketball.
Right. I mean, playing in the blackout games, the pack the places are just the greatest thing in the world. But the one moment I'll never forget was my junior year against Glenbar West in the blackout game where we had about 2 seconds left. And I hit a three from the top of the key to tie it. We end up losing in overtime, but the way the crowd just reacted, that was just amazing.
After this timeout, Polanowski comes back into the game. Greer finds Riley, open look. In and out for Michael Riley. Unfortunate call against Taylor down low there, but correct call by the referee. So Riley, 1 for 3 behind the arc to start this game, but a guy like that, got to keep shooting.
He likes his press. Oh, wow. Those type of calls are tricky because it looks like he's tripping by himself, but then the ref calls up. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's also hard to see from over here, though.
Right.
You don't have the best angle.
100%.
And obviously, the LT fans are going to react away because it's against them. But
100%.
But, yeah, this press has been working so far. They're going to settle off here for now as Kuzak checks back into the game. That's Dell now. Roscoe. A little mid-range pull-up jumper is good for Vinkus Buzelis. Hope I pronounced that right. Devils going back with their original starting five. Riley up to Chambers. He pumps, trying to find some sort of space, and he throws that one away.
Tough.
Yeah, just a miscommunication there down on the sideline between Chambers and Taylor. It's Kuzak now trying to take his time, get his offense moving. Kuzeli over to Dell. Thick now, dumping it off to Orozco. Knowing the ball's in his hand, something will happen. Buzeli, that one's up. Just off the mark. Hoffman battling for the rebound, and he finds it. see what Greer can do now. You know, he's always open to just letting it fly, too. Inside to Taylor. It looks like they called a travel there.
I don't know about that one.
Yeah, it's hard to see with the crowd standing in front of us, but that's a tough call to make, too.
Right.
Buzeli now driving on Taylor. He lets that one up the off the glass and in. Central extends their lead back up to 8 again. Caleb Greer trying to get something going on this offense. Hoffman trying to drive, loses the handle a little bit there. Now stuck with it. Just gets it over to Riley. Good screen. Greer lets it fly. That one's good. Caleb Greer. He's hit 2 big threes now in this game. Kuzak loses the handle on it. It looks like Hoffman out of bounds when he touched it, so good defense there, but Central holds on to possession.
Is Greer a Tavari Jr.?
They play very alike, yes.
All right.
Tavari, he's at Akron right now.
Yes. They have a game tonight.
As I haven't kept up with him at all, but
he's been playing well. I mean, this is sophomore season. His freshman year, he had a couple starts and everything like that. I mean, hopefully they make March Madness this year. It's good to see he's doing well.
Thick down low. Good rebound. Taylor stripped away. He's going to call the foul, though, against Thick. So momentum seeming to maybe shift a little bit here. That's Howell and Kosis checking in for Thick and Dell. LT sticking with the same 5. Chambers up top, lets it go. That one is good. Brady Chambers cuts the deficit down to 2, and this momentum has 100% shifted in this building as the Lyons are now hitting shots. They're making those threes, and they're getting back in this game quickly. Kuzak. Use it for Buzeli. He's trying to work on Greer. To Roscoe. You know, he'll let it fly from anywhere. Kosis. That one's way short. 2 badly missed shots there by the Red Devils. As the coveted air ball chant come from the crowd. Greer. Looks like a defender may have got a piece of that. Good shot nonetheless by Greer. Roscoe. That one, good defense there. Strips it away. Good inside pass to Howell. Good defense by Riley and Taylor as they push it the other way. Riley now with it. Top of the key. Taylor now. Good defense there now. Ball's going everywhere right now as Kosis down low. Buzeli. That one's off. Kuzak misses. Rebound Chambers. I mean, what do you think? This pace is very high pace these last couple possessions.
Oh, wow. That's a great move.
Caleb Greer, yeah. Great move by Greer. Just could not get it to finish.
Back and forth for sure. Down by 2. Give me some buckets.
Roscoe lets it fly. He finds the bottom of the cup and stares at the LT crowd as he backpedals. That's his 3rd 3 of the night. He's rolling against this Lions defense right now. Hoffman guarded closely. Taylor over to Riley, trying to find some sort of space. Chambers, mid-range pull-up, just off the mark. Taylor trying to keep it alive, can't hold on. Hinsdale Central making some changes now. That's Howell and Kuzak out as Thick and Dylan Orozco come in. So the 2 brothers are now the backcourt for the Red Devils. So up top to Kosis. Uzaley inside. Thick wasn't looking, and that's just a miscommunication there. Thick thought he was going to shoot it, and Uzaley thought Tyler Thick was ready for the pass, and he was not.
Unfortunate.
Yeah, half the crowd would think that, half of the crowd would think otherwise. So. Chambers. Trelly on the right wing, trying to find Greer inside. Hoffman now guarded closely by Orozco, and Hoffman just loses his handle and throws this the other way. Over to Orozco. Looks like Hoffman maybe got a piece of that. Hard to tell, and that call is going to go against Central. Believe it was on Kozis or Buzeli. As Riley and Greer will see the bench as Kuda and Pajauskas check back in. Just over 2 minutes remaining in this first half. I think these last few minutes here have been pretty eventful. Tyrese, I would say, right? Pretty
100%.
Eventful.
I hope we can get some shots here.
Kuda mid-range.
Okay, there we go.
Tyler Kuda.
We love that. That's
a
great-looking shot. Great-looking shot.
Yeah, just a nice mid-range pull-up right off the screen. As Bobby Deftos seen his first minutes now. Thick inside.
Ooh.
Well defended, but he finds a bucket as lead back to 5 for Central. Pajauskas, just over a minute 30. See if Kuda goes right back to it. He does.
Ooh,
that one.
Tough.
Dylan Orozco now dribbling through traffic. Good move. Step back 3. That one's off. Good rebound by Luke Belenko. He gets it back up top now. That's Kozis. Just under a minute left. Like we said, no shot clock in IHSA high school basketball, so they can take their time.
I mean, you love this. You love no shot clock when you're up, but when you're down,
yep,
it's just, it's not fun. You see this, they're just waiting,
Kozis
waiting.
Just taking time, and crowd's not happy with that, of
Boo.
Course.
Boo.
Foul there. I believe that's going to be on Hoffman. So Deftos will come out as Daniel Orozco will come back in. As well as Uzaley checks back in for Luke Belenko. That one's out to Buzeli. Buzelis, not sure, I believe it's Buzeli, but. Just 10 seconds left here now. We'll see what they do. That's Dylan Orozco. And he's gonna take his time. We'll see if he shoots or drives. He's gonna drive on Hoffman. Loses the ball. Hoffman, 2 seconds. He lets someone go early.
Ooh.
Hoffman let that one fly just a tad early, but I think LT started off a little slow, but they definitely picked the pace up. They're starting to hit shots. Caleb Greer was hitting shots. We saw Kuda hit a couple shots.
I feel like the second half would be a little bit different. I mean, LT's going to go in there and adjust to everything and come back out and get a W. That's what I'm feeling. How
yeah,
about
I
you?
Think, I mean, it's hard to say, but the two Orozco brothers have been playing really well, so I think that's the key focus you need to make on defense is not letting Daniel especially just let those threes fly. But you're right, they'll definitely go over what they need to fix, and hopefully they come out strong and can attack that.
100% agree with you.
That was the first half here at North Campus Fieldhouse. Hinsdale Central Red Devils lead the home Lyons 25-20. We'll be back after halftime.
So we've been doing multicam live broadcast production for our cable channel since before the internet had streaming. When the internet developed streaming, we were pioneers. We were one of the first high schools in the nation that was doing live streaming over the internet of our programming, and that has evolved over the years.
You know, there are a lot of events that go on in high school, whether it's sports, whether it's concerts, whether it's plays. You know, there's a lot of demand for, you know, live production, broadcast, streaming.
I think what I liked the most about Blackmagic Design and what they were doing and what they've been doing for the last few years is creating opportunities. They make equipment, but the equipment that they make is professional, but it's at a price point that makes it accessible, and that is what creates opportunities.
Obviously, Hinsdale Central, one of the most anticipated matchups, as we've seen some videos made by the Weirdos and the Lyons Barstool account on Instagram. You can go check those out. As Paul Nowski from the corner.
With the three in the corner, and he cannot miss to start this second
so
half.
So this year's basketball season, we started with kids that had no experience on any live broadcast. And we have a full Blackmagic camera setup.
Using the broadcast cameras as a high school student, it makes me feel like I'm learning a lot about what I'm going to be dealing with in the industry, and I'm able to interact with a camera that I'm going to be using for potentially the next 10 years of my life.
It was just intimidating because it was like the first big camera I've ever seen. But then once Karafa explained it to me, I was like, oh, okay, it's just like any other camera. It was really easy to learn.
My program is all about real-world hands-on application of skills and developing those skills through practice and exercise and preparedness for production.
Yes, I am Jason Azevedo from Realmsmith, and today I am playing Victor Hammerforge, Dwarven Fighter. Going to bust many skulls. It's going to be a very good time.
Our program is pretty robust, and because we have great equipment and great facilities, we are often invited to work on productions that go beyond the scope of the high school. I think it's a great opportunity to bring my advanced students, the ones who have a desire to be involved in this, who are hungry to learn and have opportunities, to have that real world experience, to work on productions with professionals and to learn from those professionals is absolutely crucial.
In this last year, I've learned more about the software and the equipment that I'm interacting with than I had learned previously in all 4 years of high school. So now I feel immensely prepared for the stuff that I'm going to be dealing with in college and beyond.
And here I sit on the sideline of a historic crosstown rivalry. As you hear, the Hinsdale Central crowd is right behind me, making this really fun to be announcing on the sideline. I'm Mike Badroff here to give you the Hinsdale recap going into halftime. I can talk louder than they can as we talk about Hinsdale Central and what the job they have to do to defend against the LT lead. Right now it's 25-20, and LT's defense has been struggling to keep against Hinsdale's threes and long drives, while LT on the other side has to convert for more defense to offense. Right now it's about who wants it more and who can last longer. I'm Mike Badroff, and now we have a special message for Rockathon with one of the WLTL managers.
Hi, my name is Lila Finning. I'm the social media manager. Rockathon is our local fundraiser for the high school radio station. We're accepting donations at WLTL.net/donate all weekend. It supports radio and TV, which you're broadcasting right now. If you love getting catch up on all LT sports, all LT events, and you love the music, please donate or consider tuning in. We have tons of fun stuff planned. Just like the rest of this half, we are very excited to broadcast the rest of the game. And please, please, please visit WLTL.net/donate if you want to support us.
Help yourself out, help us out, and help radio out by keeping these broadcasts going. And now back up to Campbell and Tyrese to give us the rest of the game.
We welcome you back after halftime here as the Hinsdale Central Red Devils lead the Lyons 25-20. That was Michael Badroff on the sideline there, getting a lot of hate from the Hinsdale Central crowd right behind him, but that is to be expected in a rivalry like this. Continuing on, talking about this rivalry a little bit. Different than previous years, LT has had the upper hand in this year in most sports. They beat them in football. They beat them in basketball a couple weeks ago. I believe they're 4-0 against them this year in hockey, so LT definitely has the upper hand, different than previous years, but that one is flush from Buzeli. That was just a nice move. So LT sticking with their original starting five. Hinsdale Central doing the same. Chambers now guarded closely up top. Hoffman trying to get in inside, and they are going to call a charge against Taylor there. What do you think? That the correct call there?
I think so. He kind of put his shoulder into him, and he fell down.
Yeah, good job by Tyler Fick down low to take that charge and force the turnover. As Kuzak now takes it the other way. Over to Buzeli. Trying to find space as LT goes back to they keep switching up between man and zone, but Buzeli lays that one down off the baseline. And wow, what a dunk. I was not expecting that when the ball hit his hands.
They're not playing any games today, clearly.
So LT needs to do something quickly to slow this pace down. Chambers trying to spin on Thick down low. Taken away by Kuzak. Pushes the pace the other way to Orozco. That one's blocked by Michael Riley, though. LT trying to add a little bit of flair back into their game. Great dunk by Vinkas Buzelis. Roscoe's first free throw is good. So Roscoe now at 13 points on the night. Leading scorer for the Red Devils so far, as they now extend their lead to 11. So LT needs to put some points up quickly here to stop this stampede that's over them right now. Taylor driving baseline.
Oh,
gets
yes.
The foul, and that one falls. Taylor at it for a great chance of a three-point play.
Great take. One off two, that's how you do it.
That's exactly what the Lyons needed. They needed a score, and a chance at a three-point play always helps out. As Taylor hits the free throw. 31-23 now. early, still early in the third quarter. It's Buzeli trying to drive on Taylor over to Orozco. He makes a move, drives floater up. Chambers.
Wild shot.
Yeah. Chambers, I believe, is going to get the call on that one for the block. Well, they're going to give that one to Hoffman. So Orozco back to the line on back-to-back possessions. Orozco is 3-for-3, 4-for-4 from line. I apologize. He had that and one that he converted earlier. So Orozco perfect so far tonight. Lead now back up to 10 for the Red Devils. So early start to this third quarter for the Red Devils as they jump out, extend their lead from 5-10 as Greer drives.
Good take. Great take.
Draws the foul. Can't get the basket to go, but he draws the foul. As I believe that was on Kuzak. So Greer will go to line for two. First one up and good as Tyler Thick is heading to the bench when Michael Howell comes in to replace him. Two for two from the line is Greer. A lot of early fouls in this quarter.
For sure.
That one dropped over to Howell. He's got guys open. That's Dell trying to drive.
Dribble drive action.
Buzeli, bit of a look to maybe be a double dribble there, but nothing called. It's Howell back over to Buzeli. He's going to let that one go. That one just rims out. Good rebound. Chambers swatted at by Kuzak, and that's an unfortunate foul because I believe that's that's Kuzak's third foul, so that's a foul. You cannot get there, right?
I mean, no, like, you can't at all. See, they took him out right away.
He didn't even have to swat at that ball, but he decided to it. So Dylan Orozco will come in for Kuzak. Greer gets a drive. Lets that one go, and that one
is good. Such a great take. He's fast. He's really
Very.
Fast.
Well, he plays DB and wide receiver on the football team, too, so yeah.
Wow. Is he committed to go anywhere?
I'm not sure. Huh. I don't believe so. I'm not sure. Whistle blown. Not sure what for. Maybe an off-ball foul on Pajauskas down low, it looks like. Not sure what the conversation is right now, but what'd you see? Did you see anything out there?
Or? I did not. I actually couldn't see right now because somebody's blocking me, but
I believe the talk was something with Pajauskas off the ball, but not sure. Dylan Orozco will take it in. Zaley falls down. Over to his brother. That's an errant pass, but find an open man. Howell in the corner. That one's way long. Good rebound. Just falls into Taylor's lap as Greer pushing the pace. Riley, deep three. Just off the mark. Chambers trying to hold on to it. Good timeout called. Coach Sloan.
Coach Sloan going to go draw something up on the good
Yeah, what?
Board.
LT done a good job of now getting back into this game after a slow start. What do you need to see from them on the offensive end to prove to you that they can win this game?
Well, I like to see them get some good shots going. I like to want them to swing it around the perimeter. If a three-point shot's there, but I think they're at best when they're going to the rim and attacking those open spots.
Yeah, I agree completely. I think that we know this team can shoot threes, but from what we've seen so far this game, we saw Greer, we saw Chambers, we saw Kuda. I mean, those little pull-up mid-range jumpers have been working for them.
For sure. Get into that paint. It's the best thing that can go for the Lyons right now.
Yeah, we saw Taylor get into the paint a couple possessions ago. So, yeah, a lot of fouls early on, though, in the second half. So couple guys in foul trouble early. Saw a little Kuzak with three fouls. So Eric Kozas is going to check in for the Devils. Chambers down low. Ooh. And they're going to call a charge.
Ooh, that what was a little iffy. That was a little iffy.
Yeah, Sloan is very upset on the sidelines there.
He's hoping for a flop. He did not get one.
Yeah, great job by Howell down low to take that charge, though. The ref was right there, so you never know. It's hard to say on those calls. Like, obviously, if you're the team that goes for, you're like, oh, it's obvious. If you're the 100%. Team that goes against, you're like.
100%.
Roscoe trying to step back on Greer, but nothing comes from it. Dillon driving. Got to Zaley. Foul on Taylor, I believe, down low. Not sure who the foul was on there, but it's the fifth on the Lions early in this second half. So Daniel Roscoe will go to the line. He's perfect tonight. Trying to extend their lead to seven. He does. Dillon Reddy getting ready to check in.
We love that.
For the Devils. Senior guard. Roscoe continues to be perfect, and he'll check in for Daniel Roscoe. So lead back up to eight now for the Red Devils.
Hopefully get something going here.
Taylor up top, maybe looking to take a shot. He won't. Pajauskas now. Behind the back is Riley trying to drive. Finds Greer driving.
Ooh.
Just can't get that one to go. Good move, but couldn't get it to fall as Dillon Roscoe pushing the pace now. He's going to slow it down. Kozas wanted that one to. He wanted to let that one fly, but couldn't pull the trigger. Zaley now slowing it down. They're controlling their lead. Now Kozas over to Reddy. Just short for Zaley. Rebound by Howell. Back over to Kozas in the corner. Reverse lay. Just off. Rebound Chambers. Now Riley looking to push the pace. Greer in the corner. He's open.
Ooh,
just off front rim.
Almost in.
Yeah, good look there by Greer, but couldn't get it to go.
I mean, if those were falling, it'd be a different game.
He's had a couple of those that have come really close, just couldn't get it to fall. Roscoe really loves his quick fake steps, step backs. He's been moving a lot outside as Buzeli trying to drive on Riley. Good defense by Riley. Howell in the corner. Back out to Vincas Buzeli. Now ready with it. Over to Roscoe. Pajauskas guarding him well. Driving. Staying with him. Good defense. Pajauskas kind of came across with a club a little bit there. I didn't really see the need for that, but Dillon Roscoe will go to the line now. What did he do there? He kind of just reached around and like.
Yeah, reached
hit
around
him,
yeah.
Didn't really see a need to do that. He was playing good defense before.
Got impatient.
Yep. Now Dillon Roscoe, the younger brother of Daniel, makes his first. As LT will make a couple changes here. Hoffman's coming back in, as well as Polanowski and Kuda, as Taylor, Greer, and Pajauskas will see the bench. Thick also checked back in for Howell. Second one, no good for Dillon. So LT will now come down the floor, down nine. Kuda driving off the glass, no good. trying to get his own rebound, but Thick takes it before him. Reddy now pushing the pace. Dylan Orozco trying to drive, kick out to Kozis. Reddy, three, just short. Rebound, fought for, taken away by Hoffman. He's got a man open. Lay and the foul. Couldn't get the bucket to go, but
great take.
Yeah, great take. He had a chance to drop it off to Polanowski there, but I like him taking that lay strong up the hoop and just trying to finger roll it in, I guess.
Sometimes you gotta just do it yourself.
Malenko mm-hmm. also checked in for the Devils the last time out. Hoffman's first shot is good. As Reddy now goes to the bench for Daniel Orozco. So the two brothers will man the backcourt again here. So Central sticking strong with the Orozco brothers, Kozis, Thick, and Belenko. It's Lyons. Chambers checks out, and I believe Liam Taylor checks back in. So LT sticking with this full court press again. Orozco, three, just off. Foul on Kuda down low, so Central will go to the line again. A lot of fouls.
The bonus
here.
Early.
A lot of fouls.
Gonna be the bonus soon.
I think they've been in the bonus for a while now. I think that's, I know the board only says five, but I think that's seven at this point.
Wow.
As Thick's first free throw is good. Central extends their lead. 37-29, looking to continue it now. Thick's second free throw good. 38-29 now for the Red Devils.
We got a score here. That's
yeah, still
we
still a lot
do.
Of time though.
For we got sure, 100%.
A quarter left to play. Polanowski trying to drive on Thick. Nothing comes from it. It's over to Hoffman. Taylor lets it fly. Taylor!
Great shot.
Knockdown three from Liam Taylor. He says, man in my face, he does not care. Just knocks that one down.
Great
that
shot.
Is a huge three to cut the lead down to six. Now, Central taking their time. 40 seconds left. Probably try and just wait and hold for last shot again, but LT trying to make him push the pace. I mean, we saw this at the end of the first quarter, and LT forced a turnover late, and Greer hit a three, so maybe we can see something like that again. So Daniel over his brother Dylan, guarded closely and well by Kuda. So we're 15 seconds left in this third quarter. We'll see if Central can, good defense, he stepped on the line, no call. Dylan Orozco in the corner, that's Thick up top. Daniel now driving on Hoffman. And they're going to get the foul late after refs not in view of that half-court line. It looked to me, what's the rule on that? Do they have to be fully crossed over?
If your foot touches on the line, it's over and back.
Backcourt, okay. So, yeah, it missed. It looked close from here, but it looked like he may have stepped on that line.
I think he did, too.
So Daniel Orozco will shoot two as time is about to expire in this third quarter, and he misses the first. So Greer is going to check back in to maybe work some last-second magic like he did in the first quarter. Orozco's second free throw is good. They're going to have to get this down court quickly. Polanowski into Greer. He's got to let it go. Caleb Greer
hits
the half quarter to end the third quarter. What a shot by Caleb Greer. That is a huge shot to keep LT in this game. And he has done it twice now.
Fantastic play.
Those are shots you see. I mean, those are shots guys have once in their career, right?
For sure,
and
100%.
Caleb Greer has now had it twice in one game.
It looks kind of easy to him.
Yeah, just that little one-handed, one-leg floater. That is a huge three-pointer from Caleb Greer.
Down four. Let's see what we can do in this fourth quarter.
That's a big difference from 7-4.
What do you think they'll do here in this fourth quarter? Think they'll stay with the press?
I think it's been working. I think, it's been working. They forced Central to push the ball up quickly instead of taking their time with it. And I think that has been working for them. I think they need to keep their strong defense, force Buzeli, who's been taking a lot of these shots, to keep taking those contested shots. Chambers and Taylor have done good work on the glass, so they need to keep up with that, and they need to score, obviously.
Yeah, for sure, score. They need to keep up the intensity, keep this going to this fourth quarter so they can come up with the win.
As the Lions do get ball as well. So Kuzak back in the game now. Greer inside to Chambers. Great defense by Howell, and Chambers is going to get an unfortunate foul there, just kind of tied up off that rebound. But
those are the worst kind of fouls. I mean, you're
nothing
jumping.
Nothing you can do about it.
Nothing you can do. You jump in, you come down, and just bump into someone, and you hear a whistle being blown. So next play mentality.
Thick checks back in for Howell. So Central now going with their original starting five. Zaley drives that short. Good rebound. Now Greer trying to work, drops it off. Chambers, Greer open look, doesn't take it.
Great
inside,
drive.
Off the glass, rims around and out.
Such a great drive.
Yeah, that he just drives so strong, and that's just unfortunate. I mean, there isn't really much you can do about that. Great work by Hoffman to find the board, and not sure what the call is here, and looks like Central got a timeout off in time. So just over 7 minutes left here, 39-35 Central. This game is definitely, it's had times where it's been slow, but it's definitely heating up now entering this fourth quarter.
Yeah, that's how all these LT versus Hinsdale games are. It comes down to the wire, and whoever's the toughest will come out with the win.
Yeah, as we know, last matchup, LT at Hinsdale Central, they defeated them 48-45, so that was definitely a close matchup, and looks like this game is looking to end similar to that one as well.
Definitely rather it be close than a blowout. Mm-hmm. Better for the crowd, better for the players also.
Yeah, it definitely makes the environment inside here a lot more fun, and especially as a player and a spectator as well. Kuzak has it up top now. Roscoe over to Zaley. Now he pumps against Polanowski, fakes him out, trying to drive.
Great
good defense.
Defense.
Good defense by Polanowski there. Go into Thick. Trying to work on Chambers. Short. Good rebound, Chambers. It's Greer now. Trying to push the pace, now slowing it down. He lets it fly. Ooh. Just short. Looked like he had a bit of an odd release there on that shot. He looked closer than he thought he was to his defender. Zaley trying to drive him, Polanowski. Floater up, rims out, rebound, Taylor. Now Greer inside to Chambers. And the foul, Brady Chambers.
Such a great finish. Great pass, great finish. Let's convert this. Make it a one-point game. That'd be amazing.
Yeah, great eyes by Greer there to find Chambers cutting across the middle down court. Kajauskas and Riley now checking in for Hoffman and Polanowski. Chambers now with a chance to cut it to one, and the closest it's been in a while. He connects. 1-point game now. Yeah, this is definitely where the crowd, especially this LT crowd, gets behind you right here. Any big shot or good defensive stop that LT makes, crowd will get into it, that's for sure.
Full court pressure by Greer here.
And Dylan Orozco now checks back in for Kuzak. Orozco drives to the hoop, back out to Thick. Out of Daniel Orozco. Inside to Thick, great body. And he gets that one to go. Great job against Taylor there to kind of give him a little bump. No, not enough to make have a foul, but.
That was a great play. Great
Greer
pull
mid-range
up.
Pull up. Just off the mark, rebound by Central. Daniel Orozco playing at his own pace over to Zaley. That's over to Dylan now. That's going to be an off-ball foul on Daniel Orozco, I believe, and that's a huge turn for this Lyons team. I mean, that's something they needed there. That's big.
100%. Take the lead here.
Now Pajauskas working on Kozis. Greer now drives, dishes to Chambers. He's got options. He decides to pump.
Wow.
And that one is good.
Fantastic.
Good little post fade there by Brady Chambers to cut it back to one. Lyons still hanging on here. Dylan Orozco, good screen by Thick. Just short, great rebound. Liam Taylor, big rebound there. Greer now over to Pajauskas. Taylor, good screen. Taylor, mid-range pull up. In and out. And Chambers, another unfortunate foul off a rebound.
That great one, pull up, though.
That one was right there. As you can see Chambers' little post fade.
A little dark action.
Mm-hmm. In and out for Taylor, though, is right there. 41-40 leave, 4:30 left in the fourth quarter. Kozis driving, he's got a lane. Hard foul by Taylor. So Kozis will go to line for two. Yeah, from other games I've watched and broadcasted on, this is a lot. The refs are blowing the whistle a lot of fouls.
For sure.
Kozis' first free throw is good. Extends 42-40 lead now for the Red Devils with a chance to make it three. That one's good, so just over 4 minutes left here. We'll see what Caleb Greer and this Lyons offense can do. Chambers now up top with it. Over to Riley. Taylor now to Pajauskas, trying to drive on Dylan Orozco. Cuts baseline. Again, no shot clock, so they can take their time, find their look. Chambers lets it go. Chambers, three is flush.
Fantastic.
As the Lyons tie this one up.
Crowd's getting into this one now.
Orozco slips, drives to the hoop. Huge bucket by Dylan Orozco. He wanted the foul, didn't get it. As Greer now trying to maybe push the pace a little bit. Chambers got the hot hand over to Taylor, three. Liam Taylor's three-pointer is good. And this Lyons crowd is on their feet. Lyons extend the lead to one now, and that's a good bucket by Muzeli. Central now retakes the lead, 47-46. Lyons definitely done a good job. They're hitting these deep shots. Pajauskas fumbles, recollects it. Over to Taylor now. Taylor bumps Buzeli, drives. Little floater is good. And Moses now. Roscoe. Roscoe drives on Chambers. That one, a bit of an errant pass, but Buzeli rehandles. 2:30 left now. Riley's going to get called for the foul.
A little hand check. Definitely a hand check. He had his hand on his body, so that's why they called it.
So not in the bonus yet, so. Poses to inbound. Trying to lob it up to Buzeli, and he puts it off the glass and in.
One thing I can say about this game, a lot of guys are very athletic.
Yeah, guys are getting active.
Dunks, alley-oops.
Pajauskas driving baseline, loses it, gets it back. Chambers mid-range, he finds it. Brady Chambers is hot right now. Coach Sloan, timeout. Lions hold the lead, 50-49. I mean, what a change of pace in this game. And how this game has flipped for the Lions.
For sure. They turned up the intensity to start hitting shots, playing better defense. Now it's looking like it's going their way right now, but we got 2:10 left, so we'll see what happens.
Still a lot. Yeah, definitely a lot of time left. They just got to keep playing sound defense. Obviously, we know Central, if they have the lead, they'll take as much time as they want, but it's good. Keep playing sound defense, force some bad looks, and keep applying the pressure on offense.
Seems like when LT pressures, Hinsdale starts to panic a little bit, and they start to try to get to the lane and force up these crazy shots. So hopefully we can keep going doing that.
Yeah, we've seen a couple guys throw some passes away. We saw both the Roscoe brothers drive and put up some lays, but yeah. As the patented chants from these two crowds going back and forth, especially this late and this intense of a game. What is Coach Sloan telling his team right now in this huddle?
Right now he's telling his team to keep the same intensity they have and keep getting good looks like they've been doing, and they're going to get this W. Let's
see, no changes for the Lions. Red Devils sticking with their same 5-2 with both the Roscoe brothers. Kozis now up top, guarded by Liam Taylor. LT going back to man. Greer tries to draw the charge, but Daniel Roscoe just off. Good rebound, Pajauskas. Pajauskas got to get across half, but he's trying to size up Dylan Roscoe. Greer guarded closely by Kozis, goes off the screen. Dish inside to Chambers. He's got a man in the corner, couldn't find him. Great poke by Kozis there. Kozis going all the way. Taylor, not sure if he got a hand on it or not, but great defense. Kozis, that one's off. Rebound, Taylor. Great defense by Liam Taylor. Riley pulls up for three. He hits the three. Michael Riley, he has been hot these last couple games. That is a clutch three. Dylan Orozco, that shot's way off. Liam Taylor draws the foul, and this momentum has surely switched in this game. What a turn of events.
Wow. Sloan was going a little crazy when he saw him pull it up, but once he made it, he was happy.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's not the shot you want when you're winning.
He was feeling himself.
Riley, he knew his shot, and he knew it would go. Now LT, just under a minute left, can take their time, force Central to foul. Central will foul, that's Tyler Fick. So Chambers has still got, I believe, a foul to give, so that's Kuzak now replacing Fick. I believe that's 4 on him.
Central's hearing it.
Yeah, they are. Central was giving it to LT earlier in the game, and LT now is rightfully returning the favor. Pajauskas downloaded. Big block by Buzeli.
Wow.
We knew if Liam Taylor let that one. Dylan Orozco, that is a huge three.
Every single Hinsdale game I played in, there's always a three at the end of the game.
I was going to say, if Liam Taylor laid that one down, everyone would have gone nuts, but that is a huge turn of events. That is, I think if you're Liam Taylor, you go for the easier bucket there or pass out of that, and now Central is right back into this game, just like that. 33 seconds left.
Hinsdale Central's probably going to foul.
You think so?
I think so.
Well, I think maybe they go for the steal initially off the inbound, and then if they can't get it, they foul. 100%. But they did force a bad look last time, too. But yeah, I think you're right. I think steal off the inbound. If they can't get it, they foul. Not sure if they still have one to give or not. Team sticking with their same lineups. So Chambers to inbound now. Obviously the full court press is going to be shown by Central. Chambers trying to get it in. Gets it across to Pajauskas. Pajauskas not fouling, trying to get it past half court. Chambers does. Riley trying not to lose it. Pajauskas. Now Riley is fouled. LT did a good job there of wasting just over 10 seconds of clock.
100%. Now it's knocked down. So.
Yeah, these are two huge free throws that Michael Riley's got to make here. Dylan Dell is about to check in for the Red Devils. First free throw is good. And LT extends their lead to 54-52. But this is the free throw right here. To cut it to three, this is what you need, this one right here. Michael Riley drains both clutch free throws. They got to play sound defense here. No fouls. 15 seconds left. Obviously, they're going to look for a three. They're going to go quick. Orozco lets it go. Air ball from Orozco all the way down to Riley, and he's just going to look to dribble it out. He's fouled. And, I mean, obviously, if you're Central there, you need a three, but is that the shot you want to take?
No, I don't know about that one. He kind of rushed that a little bit. Looked that look a little off balance. That's why he missed.
As all the LT fans are waving goodbye to these Central fans as they are getting out of here quickly. As LT, if Michael Riley makes one of these, two of these, it'll be game. 3 seconds left. Riley's first one is good, and that's going to be just about it for the Lyons as they look to go for a sweep on the Red Devils for the year. 2-0, improve their record to 10-15. As you hear the start the buses chant going by the LT fans. So Orozco just kind of dribbling it out, letting it fly. And the LT fans storm the court for a huge win against Hinsdale Central. Tyrese, any post-game thoughts on the game overall?
I thought it was a good game overall. I mean, LT started off a little slow, but as the game progressed, they picked it up and came out with the W. Let's go, LT.
Yeah, I think you said it right. I think they... Before half, you said they needed to make some changes, and I think they did, and some guys started hitting some big shots, and that was the turning point in this game.
That's true. It was such a great game, and I'm glad we came out with the W.
Yeah. Lyons Township defeat the Hinsdale Central Red Devils 57-52. We're going to throw it down to Michael for postgame.
Hi, I'm Mike Badger. I'm now down here with Caleb Greer. Caleb, how's that game for you, man? Being your rivals at home, defending it.
Man, it's amazing. You know, we worked for this, and before we even came out, we said we was going to win this game, and we did that.
Thank you so much, man. Congrats. It was an amazing game. What a rivalry from Hinsdale and LT. LT, beat them away, beat them at home. What LT can do? We got Brady Chambers along with Caleb Greer combining for 30 points tonight. It was an amazing game from both sides. Love to see it as that the LT whiteout crowd goes away for the rest of the night. Thank you. I've been Mike Badger for this broadcast.